And welcome back to the show, everybody. Well, Charles Barkley on CNN yesterday making headlines after he said this about religious freedom laws.
This is just about discrimination. Listen, I saw your story about those people just want flowers. They're not trying to trick you into their gay lifestyle. They just want flowers. And I love it, you know, typically of the South, where I'm from, all these rednecks hide behind the Bible. That's what they do. That's one of the reasons the South is behind in everything. They always hide behind the Bible. It's strictly about discrimination.
Charles, who apparently gets paid by the word, took the Christian owners who don't want to serve gays to task further.
They have selective amnesia. They just don't like gay people. I wish they would just say that. And let me say this. If they want to be like that, I think they have the right to be like that. I think the biggest problem I have, we as a country or as a state of Indiana, they can't make it a law.
And the former Philadelphia 76er not mincing his words, calling social conservatives who supported the Indiana religious bill in its original form bigots. Heather, you're from Philadelphia. You used to wear a Barkley jersey around.
I actually always have liked Sir Charles, but I think on this particular issue, he's way out of line. You know, it's really getting frustrating. There's homophobic, there's a word for that. Racist, he brought that up in there too, talking about racism. What is the failure to recognize that these people are being anti-Christian? You know, we had 174 Christians slaughtered this week, and the thought that you can get on television and call them rednecks, and he called them at another point that we didn't play religious nut jobs, it's completely unacceptable. There has to be tolerance on both sides. I understand that the gay and lesbian community wants recognition, so do Christians, and they both have to be recognized, not just one side.
You're a Pennsylvania guy as well. He represented your basketball team for years. Hall of Famer. People like his opinion sometime, but they don't like this.
Well, I think his opinion when he's analyzing basketball is great. I don't think when he's making overall statements, because Heather's exactly right. So rednecks, people hiding behind the Bible, all of a sudden these are bad people. But then he says at the end, well, but I respect the fact that they're allowed to have that opinion. Well, you just got done trashing them. So it's hard. It's hard. And this is not against Charles Barkley. I have too many people that are like that. I think we are a country that respects every individual's rights. By the same token, if you were to look at our Bill of Rights, the first 10 amendments, the First Amendment, very interestingly, I think it's only about 47, 48 words, the first thing we talk about is religious freedom. So why were the founders so concerned about that? And why was that the first thing that came to their mind back when they were structuring this? That's just basically who we are. Listen, I don't consider myself a homophobic. I think that maybe Mr. Barkley somehow got a headline out of it, and I think that too often it's about headlines. It's not about things that we really need to get in the headlights and say, let's get this thing settled. There's people on both sides that have opinions. Let's respect both people's opinions.
A cheap and easy narrative for people not paying attention, right? Rick, as you know, Mr. Barkley is polling very high for the Democratic nomination.
Yes, he's one of our front runners.
Where am I going with this? Yeah, it's very interesting that an NBA and NCAA basketball analyst gets as much press as he does for political
news. Well, I got to tell you, initially when I thought about this, I agreed with the congressman and Heather. But now that my guru on all things social and spiritual has told me how to think, I have to agree with Charles. Who cares what Charles Barkley says? It was ridiculous. Look, as I've said here all week long, this is a really interesting situation because both sides of this are right. So for Charles Barkley to stand up there and call somebody a bigot or a racist is just wrong. Look, the LGBT community in this country has moved forward in major strides, and God bless them for it. But the reason it's happened is because of Americans who finally came to understand that their tolerance was required so that their fellow Americans could have the rights they're entitled to. Well, you know what? You don't get to turn around and be intolerant for people who have certain religious beliefs. They're not trying to hurt you. It's what they believe. So a little tolerance is in order going that way too.
Heather, don't you think that for Charles Barkley to make such a provocative opinion like this, that he should have at least won one NBA championship? Right?
I do think it's dangerous because so many people are not well informed because they don't have time and they have lives and the holidays are coming up. And so they catch this and they like him and they think, well, that kind of makes sense to me. And then it does influence people's opinions. So when you say, who cares? Unfortunately,
well,
some people
do
care what he has to say.
But they ought to be able to think to the next level. And go,
I want to get your thoughts on how the Republican Party, or at least Mike Pence, handled that situation? In other words, let's say you were governor of your state and this came about. How would you, I know it's easy now in 2020 hindsight, but what were your thoughts when you saw this unfold this week as a Republican?
Well, when I first saw it, I mean, I know Mike, we were colleagues together. I don't think there's a finer person. And I'm talking about a solid man. And I know what he believes. I know he has such great faith. He would not be somebody who would discriminate against somebody else. By the same token, in his position, he's looking at law that was passed by
his politically, how did he handle it?
Well, I think, but you know what? I think everybody has, when it comes to looking at 2020, after 2020 vision, after it's over in hindsight, I think he approached it going in the way he thought he should approach it. Mm-hmm. I think if he had it to do over again, he'd probably say it a little bit differently. Don't we all?
Yeah. I know it's easy to say now. Anyway, coming up next, it's potluck time. This is The Daily Wrap, only on Newsmax.